In 1984, I was born. My parents bought this property when I arrived and decided that here, nestled in the bush in Gulf Harbour, is where they would like to build the home they'd always dreamed of. So we all moved in with my grandparents while the building commenced. It began with a little house made for my mother, my father, and myself. Soon it became clear that this was not going to be a small family. When Matt arrived, we needed to go bigger, much bigger. All the while, my parents, with the indispensable assistance of my brother and I, were lovingly planting the property with native trees, an orchard, and building tracks through the bush, which would later play host to the world's best games of hide and seek. Once Fraser and Mitchell turned up, there were four of us boys, and as a last resort for peace and quiet during the hot summer holidays, my parents were coerced into providing the ultimate in entertainment. A swimming pool, solar heated, which allowed our games of pool tag to continue well into autumn, and perhaps at times beyond the point that it was healthy to do so. But this family retreat was home to more than just the six of us. I can recall four cats, a faithful dog, dozens of chickens, a couple of roosters which I now suspect ended up as dinner, as well as a family of ducks who happily commuted between ponds filled with fish, frogs and tadpoles. Typically, my younger brother Matt was the first of us to really grow up. He moved to Brisbane after high school, although he's back to visit a lot. I waited until university to move out of home, but try to pop back now and then for mum's macaroni and cheese, which is without equal. I'm not exactly sure where the time all went, but I'm told that Fraser is trying to decide between the various halls of residence. Apparently that means he's old enough to start university himself soon. And Mitch has just a few years of high school left to finish up. All of a sudden, the house we'd built seemed a little big, and our parents decided it was time to find the place they'd like to spend the next 20 years. And so it is with great sorrow that I announce that the house I grew up in is for sale. Us kids decided that if we're going to move out of our family home, we want it to go to someone who will love it for the same reasons we did. A young family who can appreciate the bush for its great hiding spots, who'll feed the fish and explore the walkways through native trees. They'll enjoy the fresh fruit and veggies, the basketball court we made, the swimming pool we nagged for, and most importantly, take really good care of our chickens. I guess we hope it'll be another 20 years before we see our old house back on the market. And by then, we reckon Mitch will be just about ready to buy the home that he raises his family in.